I'm better, so much better now. Look to the skies, give me life, we're together now. We've only just begun, hypnotized by drums. Until forever comes, you'll find us chasing the sun.
So we brought the Bowl of Greatness out. There was 13 medals yesterday, kinda. And, you know, in the 24 hours. So we're just going to draw them out. We're going to talk about one at random. Danny,
great,
go ahead.
Music.
Because they've all got a story, and I can bore people for hours on these. Who'd you get?
Andy Murray. Andy Murray. Gold, yeah.
Who is Andy Murray? So this grumpy, sour-faced screamer, isn't he? And that has a really lovely, dry sense of humour and very soft off the court as well. Who is, in some people's mind, Britain's greatest ever sportsman. Two Wimbledon titles, two Olympic titles, a US Open in the finals of the other two Grand Slams, and a runner-up, hopefully to do better than that. You know, you would look at him now, the way Djokovic is playing, if that's not a temporary blip, we could see some amazing things. But I was watching him, I watched all of, obviously I watch him all the time. He is, in my mind, and this is no better company I can play him, he reminds me of a Mexican world champion boxer. You know, when you watch him play, you can beat Andy Murray in points, but you don't knock him out, you know? He is rough, and he is ready, and he is vicious.
Chisel chin.
Yeah. Do you get my point? You know, when you see certain fights and certain... And I think Mexico produces boxes like this, as Bonsi talks about time and time again, of an ilk, that their hearts are just the size of their entire chest.
Yeah.
And I think that impresses me more than any medal hanging around his neck or trophy that he lifts aloft on centre court.
He's a grinder, isn't he? He's a grinder. You just can't, as you said, you can't finish him off. He, you know, he fights for every point. He runs for every ball. But, you know, he can play good tennis as well. You know, I think, you know, he was a bit more like that in his earlier career as well. But I think, you know, he's changed his coaches quite a lot and tried to become a bit more kind of flamboyant with his shot making and stuff like that. But he's just a grinder, and his spirit is determination, and you could see what it meant to him when he won as well. The emotion, he didn't actually kind of know what to do. And he's been like that with his Wimbledon kind of victories as well. And
what he's done in the last couple of months, I mean, I'm not now entirely sure Carl Frampton's going to win Sports Personality of the Year.
Yeah, that's killed him.
Is it okay to cry now in tennis? I mean, everybody does it. Del Potro does it. Djokovic even does it now, the man who I didn't think had tear ducts. And Andy Murray, is he one of our greatest blubbers? He certainly goes on the list. I mean, he's Gaza-esque. I mean, the man is Gwyneth Paltrow with a tennis racket.
Did he cry?
Yeah. What do you mean, did he cry?
He did in the end.
I think he cried when he won the first set. Oh, yeah, he loves to cry when he wins. Some people don't like. Some people say not on the. Perry Groves, if he was here, he would say, well, "Hold on a second here."
You wouldn't be having that, would he?
I love it. I think, and it shows what it means, as you say, Danny. So, given in mind that when tennis started in the Olympics, the best players didn't turn up. It had the same vibe as maybe golf has. It had this time around.
Mm.
But then you see the guy who means it and what it means to him. Is tennis a bona fide Olympic sport, or are we being hypocrites because it's been allowed so many Olympics to develop to where it is now?
No, I think you've got to credit the players who turned up for it.
Yeah.
It was brilliant. You know, these, let's say, top stars, and you just mentioned him saying he's the greatest British athlete.
When I'm 70, if I make it that old, and I'm working on East Belfast Digital Radio, and they say
they probably wouldn't
and they say to me, who's your five greatest British sportsmen, and I'm doing my list, you know, that I've witnessed in 70 years, so he's on that list as I try and work out who the five are, right? He is that phenomenal. And we go, you know, Tim Henman deserves credit, actually, you know, for what he did, because Tim Henman was the best male British tennis player for so many generations.
Yeah.
But, you know, it's blown out of the water, but what Andy's done. But I'm pretty sure I won't say it again, no matter who he inspires, because it's not just about, he is also phenomenal. I mean, he is one of the best in the greatest era.
100%. I mean, something else.
Don't forget what Andy Murray says. Andy Murray's mother said in the sports breakfast earlier, says, Paul, so you win the Olympic medal, what's the first thing you do, guys? What do you do?
Get drunk.
Oh, mate. It'd be embarrassing. Like, you've
wasted.
Oh, you would be annoyed if you weren't doing a Freddie Flintoff in a pedalo somewhere in Barbados, right?
Or ring your mum first.
You do all that, but you wouldn't sleep for a while.
No.
Right, okay. What would you do, Mickey? What would be the same thing? Party time? 2-3 weeks?
Yeah, I'd get wasted, yeah.
Yeah, Andy Murray's just went to Cincinnati for a tournament.
Oh, positive after the weekend. Klopp's so good as well.
Yeah, it's getting more out. And Coutinho was just... continues every season to get better and better, and is
say it quietly, Colin.
I know. Just listen. We'll talk about that a little bit. We'll talk about that in my last show on September 2nd. The transfer window's closed. We'll talk about how good he is then. He won't be going anywhere. Why would he? He's not mad. Let's.
I've only just begun, hypnotized by drums until forever comes. You'll find us chasing the sun. They said this day wouldn't come, and we refuse to run. We've only just begun. You'll find us chasing the sun.